شريك له، شهادة عليها نحيا وعليها نموت وبها نبعث إن شاء الله. ونشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا وإمامنا ومعلمنا الخير محمدًا صلى الله عليه وسلم أرسله الله بالحق وبالهدى ودين الحق هادياً وبشيراً، أرسله الله ليخرج الناس من الظلمات إلى النور، أرسله الله بدين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره الكافرون ولو كره المشركون. وبعد، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. واتقوا الله واعلموا أن الله مع المتقين، واتقوا الله لعلكم تفلحون. وبعد، my dear brothers and sisters, I bear witness that there is no God but Allah. I bear witness that there is no God but God, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger and seal of prophecy. Allah sent him with guidance and a book of light to guide humanity to the straight path and to the perfect religion and way of life. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower his peace and mercy and blessings upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his blessed family and his companions. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to follow their footsteps till the day of judgment. My dear brothers and sisters, I advise you and myself before you on this day, the best day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created, Yawmul Jum'ah, the day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be a festival for the believers, the day of Friday. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it a blessed day, to accept our prayers, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless every single day and to enable us to reach the month of Ramadan, and to enable us to revive the nights of Ramadan with prayers and Quran, and to enable us to revive the days of Ramadan with fasting, and to accept from us our fasting, Allahumma ameen, and to make it a Ramadan that is accepted, and to make it a means to forgive our sins. Brothers and sisters, the word Ramadan in the Arabic language comes from the word Armadahul Har, the Arabs would say, which means that the heat has given him a heat stroke or a sunburn. And it is taken this language or this word or this meaning because the fasting of the month of Ramadan burns the sins of the human being, burns the sins of the person who fasts to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala imanan wa ihtisaban, out of faith and out of trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not fasting out of joining the society in a social habit and routine, not fasting out of health purposes, not fasting for our own purposes, but fasting for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fasting is a secret that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept between him and between the person who fasts. You cannot fool people. You can fool people, but you cannot fool Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when it comes for fasting. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Ghudba sa'imu." There may be a person who fasts a month from Ramadan, laysa lahu siyamihi illa al-ju'a wal-'atash. He takes nothing out of his fast the entire month except for hunger and thirst, nothing else. And he will miss or she will miss on the point of fasting, and that is achieving taqwa. Kutiba alaykum siyam kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqun. And achieving taqwa is not an easy job, and it's not an easy task, and it requires planning. Brothers and sisters, in last Friday we spoke about planning, and some of you, planning itself is very easy. It's not a rocket science. It doesn't need a degree to be able to plan for the month of Ramadan. All you need to do, whether young or old, a man or a woman, all you need to do is to sit down, write down your goals for this month, and write down the means through which you will achieve these goals. But one of you might say, you know, what does planning and strategic planning has to do with ibadah, with worship? It's just a bunch of do's and don'ts. We stop eating and drinking, and we do certain things, and that's it. Brothers and sisters, planning, strategic planning, is not a fancy idea. It's not an idea for people of business or engineers or people who, you know, plan for work or life. Planning is a religious duty. It's a Quranic injunction. It's a prophetic sunnah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam planned his entire life for every day he planned. And in the Quran, there are hints and directions along the Quran that tells us that we need to be planning for our religion, for our hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَذْكُرُ اللَّهَ فِي أَيَّامٍ مَعْدُودَةٍ. Remember your Lord in days that are numbered, that are specific and that are planned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not an arbitrary religion. It's not a religion that we practice, you know, out of whims and out of feelings. وَذْكُرُ اللَّهَ فِي أَيَّامٍ مَعْدُودَةٍ. Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in days that are specifically numbered and planned. إِنَّ عِدَّةَ الشُّهُورِ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ 12 شَهْرًا. The numbers and the plans for months in accordance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is 12. The lunar months is 12. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَخَلَقَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ فَقَدَّرَهُ تَقْدِيرًا. He created everything in the universe and everyone in the universe. فَقَدَّرَهُ تَقْدِيرًا. And He planned for this creation. He did not create anything out of play. He didn't create anything without proportion, without planning, without being precise. وَخَلَقَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ فَقَدَّرَهُ تَقْدِيرًا. إِنَّا كُلَّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقْنَاهُ بِقَدَرٍ. Indeed, everything we have created according to a divine plan. Strategic planning from the time Allah created the creation. إِنَّا كُلَّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقْنَاهُ بِقَدَرٍ. وَخَلَقَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ فَقَدَّرَهُ تَقْدِيرًا. وَكُلُّ شَيْءٍ عِنْدَهُ بِمَقْدَارٍ. And everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does, everything that Allah creates, everything that He plays, every time, every day, every month, every injunction, every place, every worship that we are instructed to do is created for a purpose and for a reason. And our job is to follow, and our job is to achieve the purposes of these worships. إِنَّا كُلَّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقْنَاهُ بِقَدَرٍ. And these are all, and there are many other ayats. These are only the ones that come to my mind when it comes to planning in the Quran, in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creation and handling of the business of this creation. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would tell his sahaba and his companions to plan for their lives, for their children, for their families after them. الثلث والثلث كثير. أن تبر ورثتك أغنياء خير من أن تبرهم عالة يتكففون الناس. He told his companion, one of his companions, that you should leave and plan for your family in case of death. You should plan their lives for them so that when you die, they are not left by themselves out in the wild. الثلث والثلث كثير. So you may leave your family and your children and your family after you, the people that are dependent upon you, you leave them well off is better than leaving them in need. Knocking every door to plant or to be able to survive in this world. أن تذر ورثتك أغنياء خير من أن تذرهم عالة يتكففون الناس. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم also said in a different hadith, ما ملأ آدمي وعاء شرا من بطن بحسب ابن آدم أكلات يقمن صلبه فإن كان لا محالة فثلث لطعامه وثلث لشرابه وثلث لنفسه. That the son of Adam should be careful, because the worst vessel you would fill in your life is your own stomach, our own stomachs. This is the worst vessel that we would fill. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if you have to and if you must, then eat the third and the third and the third. One for drinking, one for eating, and one for you to be able to breathe. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam even telling us to plan how much we eat. Not just eat out of our desire to eat or to be full, or we like this food or this or that. So the point is I'm trying to make is not picking on how much we eat. But the point is that I'm trying to tell you with proof that planning is a prophetic sunnah. That planning is a Quranic injunction. And it is a religious duty upon every and each one of us to plan for these seasons of worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And with that being said, we move to the second segment of this khutbah. Brothers and sisters, please, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make abundant space for you in this world and in the one who comes, inshallah. Please make space for your brothers who are waiting to be seated. Jazakumullah khair. May Allah reward you. If you have a space that you can gratefully share with brother, with one of the brothers, please do so. May Allah reward you all. And the second segment, the second point in this khutbah that I want to make is that, brothers and sisters, do not aid the shaitan and do not do the work of shaitan during the month where the shayateen are shackled. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when the month of Ramadan comes, إِذَا جَاءَ شَهْرُ رَمَضَانِ فُتِّحَتْ أَبْوَابُ الْجَنَّةِ The doors for heavens will be open wide. وَغُلِّقَتْ أَبْوَابُ النَّارِ And the doors for hell will be shut tight. وَصُفِّلَتِ الشَّيَاطِينِ And the shayateen will be shackled. Brothers and sisters, some of us, maybe many of us, maybe few of us, who knows, maybe none of us, but some people, some Muslims, some religious people in every religion, they only worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in certain seasons. They don't worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala consistently. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to cure us from this illness if we are afflicted by this illness. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to cure the brothers and sisters who may be afflicted by this illness. But some people do so. Maybe because they are lazy, maybe because life takes us, maybe whatever reason it is. But some people worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in seasons of worship, like Ramadan, like the season for Shawwal or this or that. They worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when there's an occasion where the community is worshiping collectively. Brothers and sisters, the only one that doesn't want you to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the shaytan, whether it's in seasons or all year long. But there are brothers and also sisters, there are people who discourage their brothers who only worship in seasons. They will say, you are a hypocrite. People are hypocrites. They only come to the mosque, they only worship, they only fast, they only read the Quran, they only pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they only give in charity when there's a season. And everyone is doing it. They are hypocrites. They are not part of this community. They are not real or true Muslims. Brothers and sisters, by doing so, we are doing the job of the shaitan, who is shackled during this month. Allah has made it easy for us to worship him. Then it's okay for some people to be lazy. Not okay for them to be lazy, but it's okay for them to return to Allah during the month of Ramadan. Let them return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during this month. Let them return sincerely to Allah, raise their hands and ask Him to give them stability on the straight path, on this religion, even after Ramadan, inshallah. But do not be an aid for the shaitan. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have been narrated that the Prophet told that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one of the Sahaba committed a certain sin, and he was brought to him. He was given his punishment, proper for his sin or crime that he committed. And then the other Sahaba around him started shaming him, saying, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shame you. How dare you do such and such thing? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that's a sound hadith. He said, لا تقولوا ذا. Don't say that. لا تكونوا عونا للشيطان على أخيك. Do not aid the shaitan against your brother. He has taken his punishment. He has taken his share of the punishment. Do not aid the shaitan against your brother. Be an aid for him, not against him. So brothers and sisters, if you know anyone who doesn't worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who doesn't know how to even make wudu except when it comes to Ramadan, who doesn't fast except when it comes to Ramadan, he doesn't read the Quran except when it comes to Ramadan, do not aid the shaitan against them. Welcome them. Bring them to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do not do the job of the shaitan during the time when the shaitan is shackled. And this brings us to the third point of this khutbah, inshallah. As the month is unfolded, as the month starts upon us, brothers and sisters, let us start with repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, Inna Allah yuhibbu at-tawwabin wa yuhibbu al-mutatahhirin. Those who repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala often, those who return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala often, and those who purify their hearts often, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves them. So let us start this month with returning to Allah and having a sincere tawbah and repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At-ta'ibu min al-dhanbi kaman la dhanbala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the one who repents from sinning is like someone who has never sinned before. The one who repents from sinning is like someone who hasn't sinned before. So before the time of Ramadan comes upon you and takes you by surprise, return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala right this second. Do not delay it. You might not be able to actually make it until the end of this day, or even tomorrow, or even the beginning of Ramadan. So right this second, return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make sincere tawbah, make sincere istighfar, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you. At-ta'ibu min al-dhanbi kaman la dhanba lahu. At-ta'ibu min al-dhanbi kaman la dhanba lahu. The one who repents to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is like the one who has never sinned. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله العلي العظيم. لي ولكم أدعو الله أنتم مؤمنون بالإجابة. Pray to your Lord and have faith that your prayers. Be sincere استغفار. Ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى to forgive you. التائب من الذنب كمن لا ذنب له. التائب من الذنب كمن لا ذنب له. The one who repents to Allah سبحانه وتعالى is like the one who has never sinned. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العلي العظيم. لي ولكم أدعو الله أنتم مؤمنون بالإجابة. Pray to your Lord and have faith that your prayers will be accepted إن شاء الله. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونسترضيه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. Brothers and sisters, the last point that I would like to make in this khutbah inshallah is that before Ramadan starts on Sunday nights, bring back the Qur'ans from the shelves. We know that many of us does not really have a consistent relation with the Quran except during the month of Ramadan. Make sincere promise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that this will be the end of this severed relation with the Quran. Bring back the Qurans from the shelves, brothers and sisters. Recite the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during the day and during the night. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان. The month of Ramadan is the month of Quran. So recite the Quran often, recite it. Even if you don't speak the Arabic language, brothers and sisters, take the occasion and take the time in Ramadan to learn, even if it's one ayah. And if you are someone who already knows how to recite the Quran, this can be a task that you add and a commitment that you add to yourself and a goal that you add to your list of goals in this month of Ramadan to teach someone who doesn't know how to recite the Quran, even if it was a child, even if it was a family member, teach them how to recite the Quran. Share the Quran with the non-Muslims. This can be another goal, brothers and sisters. You have no idea. Sometimes people, they don't know that they want to be Muslims until they start reading the Quran. So share the Quran with people and share the barakah of the Quran and the guidance of the Quran with others, brothers and sisters. اللهم اغفر وارحم وتجاوز عما تعلم إنك أنت العزيز الأكرم. اللهم عافنا واعف عنا. اللهم عافنا واعف عنا وآتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر.